Hey everyone, Andrew from Carlson Cash. Today we're going to discuss some of the apps within bank account management in SAP. Creating accounts is something that's somewhat new when moving from an ECC system to S/4HANA, because in ECC, this was all configuration and IT support staff would have to handle it. In S/4HANA, the functionality is more on the user side and it's handled by the Treasury users. The Treasury users are more in tune with the account creation and account closing activities, so it makes sense that they manage this instead of having IT manage them. Once the accounts are in the system, now the business has a central view to all the accounts, and we don't have to reference spreadsheets to understand what accounts we have, where they are, all those details. There are fields in the system where we can handle all of that. So now I'm going to go into the system. We can talk through some of the functions that are tracked within bank account management. Okay, now we're in the system. I'm going to go into the Manage Bank Accounts app. And we can just filter this report, similar to how the other reports we've viewed, but I'm just going to look at our company code we've been looking at, 9100. So now that we're in here, we can look, here's all the accounts that are managed within 9100. I'm going to drill into one of these. And this just houses all of the different information for this account. So if you look at up here, we have some header information, what's our account number, what bank is it held at, currency, bank country, all that stuff. We can start scrolling down and we have our general data here, what type of account it is, what the SWIFT code, if we have, you know, address information that we want to put on here, where this bank is located, that is in there too. Can scroll down. Bank relationship. We don't have times in here right now, but that's just if we want to put in what's the cutoff time for domestic payments, cross-border payments, just as a reminder, okay, if we're making payments out of this account, when is that cutoff? We can also look at the bank statement data. What this is going to do is when we can look at a bank statement monitoring app that really says, okay, has this statement been loaded? What's the difference between the GL versus what was reported on the bank statement? Stuff like that. That's why we have yes here. We scroll down, house bank account connectivity. So when we've been looking at some of these apps, we've seen house bank account. It's just a way to identify what bank branch our account is at, and then also what account we're really looking at. And this will just help tie this account to other areas within SAP. So that'll work more for cash management and bank recon and payments. If we want to set up our payment approvers or add our signatory list on overdraft limits, that's all in here. Wanted to show that there's a lot of things that you can tag your accounts with, and just anything that you need to track on your account, you can put within this Fiori app. Another thing I wanted to highlight is if people are changing your accounts, you can click at View History and you can see what changes were made at what times. There's also a function to approve changes. So if somebody makes a change, somebody opens an account, somebody closes an account, that can be set up too. So by default, you can set up a dual approval. So if one person makes the change, somebody else has to approve it if they have access. You can also use SAP's workflow for the account changes. All right. I'm going to go back to the Fiori screen. And also, I wanted to highlight this Manage Bank Accounts Bank Hierarchy view. So if you remember, we looked at this Manage Bank Accounts and we had to scroll down. You see each account and there's a lot of details in there trying to figure out what accounts you're drilling into. We can look at the Bank Hierarchy view. Okay, so now we're in the Bank Hierarchy view. Now we can see all of the different banks that we hold accounts at. And so let's say we drill down, let's stay within JP Morgan. We can look in there and see each bank branch we have listed in here, where are the accounts, and we can really drill into this and view the account the same way that we were looking at it before, but this just has an easier way to look at these accounts and search through your accounts. Okay, I hope this gave you an idea of how the bank account management function works within SAP. The different fields that can be edited, how the accounts can be approved. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out. Thank you.